All right, it's 5:30. I call this meeting to order. This meeting is being videotaped. And do we want to start, Ray, with the town clerk position?
Well, if you let me throw in a quick, there are no minutes to review and there are no project updates, then...
Then that brings us right there.
It brings us right there anyways.
Yeah, okay. So we have a couple of applicants that we need to review.
Yes, and Susan?
And one applicant is here.
One applicant is here.
Have a seat.
And then, having come to the meeting 2 weeks ago, I don't believe Doreen Stevens is coming tonight.
Okay, that was my question to you, actually, in starting this, is do we start without Doreen here yet? Or is she not coming because she was here 2 weeks ago? Okay.
Can you just say your name so that Janet can tell whether she's picking you up or we gotta slide that mic?
Susan McComb.
Hi, Susan, and welcome to our meeting.
Thank you.
All right. So I guess we could start with, what would you like to tell us about yourself and your desire to have this permission before we get started, or this position?
I don't know. What would you like to know about me? I've been a resident of Gill since 2003. I live on Dole Road. My in-laws have lived here for 15 million years.
I mean, you have a nice resume.
Thank you.
With a diverse background, but none of it is civic.
It is not.
What's making you think about that at this point, if anything? I mean,
just branching out. I like to learn, and saw the thing, and I said, well, I've taken minutes. I do have, you know, an accounting background. I did get my degree on Saturday of the 2nd of June, thinking of continuing on with my education, and just said, you know, it's different.
Okay. In the process, have you gone online at all to find out what a town clerk responsibilities are?
I tried and I couldn't find anything, you know, like it just said the minutes and whatnot, so that would be one of my questions to you, is what really is entailed in that?
The town clerk could answer that question better than I could, I think, or better than probably any of us could. I kind of off the cuff often say their number one job is keeper of the records.
Okay.
I also will off the cuff say their number one job is to keep whoever the three people that occupy these seats are legal. It's the checks and balances in the democracy.
Okay.
You know, obviously, they would take care of all elections.
Posting meetings.
Posting minutes, posting meetings. Mm-hmm. In this town, we've made them the person for public records requests. That's who they all go through. So I also sit on the Board of Health. If the Board of Health received a public records request, one of my first things I have to do is notify Linda if it came direct to me so that she can track. And then one of the things that she will do is be on me about this date has come or this date's coming. Have you, if I don't keep her informed of what I've done with that record, she's going to be making sure that we're meeting those standards where we need to. So.
Linda's years of experience have made her a very good resource for the legal implications of what we do and the legal implications of the, like Randy said, checks and balance between the town clerk and the select board or the town administrator. Ray is very good with that, but having a second person in that other position.
And I'd love to learn that stuff. I was clerk for the church, and that was one of the things I really enjoyed doing, was to make sure our minutes were correct to our bylaws and to a lot of times Robert's Rules of Orders, and to to keep that balance, and the same thing to tell the pastor and the board, you know, this is what we need to be doing, this is the date we need to be involved on, you know, this is next what's coming up, we need to do this meeting by that date. So I, that's, yeah. And learning, and I'm sure I can do it. I'm no confident. I might stumble a little, but I'm sure I can do it.
I have no doubt that you can do it as well.
And is Linda, you know, if anybody takes over, is Linda more than willing to be that person to?
Linda's going to stay on in some capacity.
As assessor's clerk.
Okay.
Yeah.
But she will be around.
Okay.
Yeah.
And I don't want to speak for Linda, but I would say Linda's dedication to the town of Gill is, I don't think she would let anybody just sink.
Right.
I just, that's not who she is.
When I passed on at the clerk and to the church, that's the same thing I did. Said to the guy, this is what you need to be doing. You know, any questions, give me a call. More than willing to.
So the hours, it's a position that doesn't have technically a supervisor. It is by tradition in Gill at this, and I would like to say forever, but at this point, an elected position.
Okay.
So as an elected position, you really, the supervisors would be the residents of Gill. However, we would ask that anybody who has that office posts hours.
Okay.
And meets those posted hours, and how many hours a week it takes, I don't know. You know, I know what Linda does, and as I've said for years, the next person may be not as efficient and might need more hours.
Right.
The next person may be, and it'll amaze me if it is, but more efficient and take less hours. But
well, she has the advantage of doing it for a long time,
yes,
so
does.
The next person is probably at a disadvantage.
And it wouldn't surprise me if the next person, if Linda's hours here, the next person's go up and then taper back to Linda's.
Right.
Or somewhere near or less. And I guess most importantly for me is whoever takes this, they're not going into Linda's job. They're going into their job that Linda used to have.
Right.
It won't be the same. It isn't the same for our treasurer and tax collector. They're two new people replacing the one that wasn't those. So.
Right.
Okay.
I'm letting you really take the lead on this because you're the HR guy out of the three of us.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of what you do, I do see a lot of public. So you obviously deal with a lot of public. People are calling for birth certificates, death certificates,
marriage
licenses, all that stuff.
Yeah. And you present very well.
Thank you.
You're presenting well in front of us
right now,
and that gives me.
I've been in customer service since I was about 17. I was kind of thrown into it. One of my jobs that I do is buy back books, and so I was thrown into that at the age of 16, 17, and I work at Big Y, so I've always just been customer service orientated.
Right.
And it frustrates me when people don't handle customers right.
You lose them fast.
You do.
Yeah.
You do.
I did a lot of years as service manager in foreign car repair shops. That's a job that can be right in the line of fire.
Yep.
You know, the two things that people hate doing are bringing their car in to spend money on having it fixed and getting dental work.
Yep.
Boy, sometimes I'd have customers that were doing both in the same day. They were a lot of fun.
Sometimes I think I'd rather the dental work, honestly.
At least you have something out of it when you come through the dental.
No, at least they give you something to take away the pain.
Right.
Okay.
That was my job.
I don't have any much more questions.
Say, is there anything that's not on here that you'd like us to know?
What do you mean by that?
Well, there's a could be just your personal interest, your.
My personal interest is learning.
Okay.
I had kids young, and I put everything aside, and my youngest daughter graduated from school a couple years ago, and. One day I disappeared and everybody said, where'd you go? And I said, I signed up for GCC. I'm going to college.
Good for you.
And I said, yeah, it's me
nice.
Time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's me. I want to learn. I want to get my degree. I want to.
I just was watching something on the news the other day, I think it's Missouri, has a thing where the state colleges offer to retired folks $10 a credit.
Yeah.
Go to any college.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
Wow.
I think people should always want to learn. I am the type that, even at Big Y and other jobs, I want to know how my job affects somebody else.
Mm-hmm.
So I want to know the next person's somewhat positioned so that I can do my job efficiently, effectively, and know how it affects the next group. I don't want to do a sloppy job and find out I've caused somebody else a lot of headaches to correct my job. I want to know how to do it to make sure that it's easier for the next person when I pass it on. If I work for you guys, you're going to hear about it because I want to know how it affects you.
Be more working for the town.
Yeah,
but whatever.
Yeah,
I want to know how to fix that too. But
yeah, but that's
that's how I see things. Is always is knowing how my job affects the next person.
Well, we are making a decision on appointing someone temporarily.
Mm-hmm.
So it would have the appearance at this point,
right,
of working for us because we are at this point the decision makers. But it's going to be the town,
right,
that are the decision makers at
the next
election. So that really shows that you are working,
right,
you know, whoever holds this position really is working for the town,
right,
and answers to the town in that
way. Raise the gatekeeper in town hall, and by that, you know, he helps a lot of the people when they come through the door, and he kind of helps the other offices, kind of keeps things going in the right direction, but really the other offices are all elected positions, and they don't report to us per se, they don't report to Ray. You know, it's nice when the relationship is right and it works well.
Yeah, we help each other out.
Mm-hmm.
Well, boys, the three of us have a tough job ahead.
But I will say it's nice to have two very qualified candidates.
Yeah.
It's not a bad thing to have a tough job when it's that way.
Right. Right.
It's better than the other way, so.
I agree.
Yeah. It'd be easier if one of them were not.
Yes. Much. Much. But, you know, the way we're fortunate that way, so it's an okay thing.
Yeah.
Okay.
And we do all of our deliberation in front of the camera,
yeah,
and
questions, thoughts?
No, I have a tough decision.
The only question I have is which one of those two well presenting candidates am I in favor of,
mm-hmm,
and why? One, it's real easy to say that the last person that is in front of you is the one that has impressed you because it's fresh.
Right.
Yep.
2 weeks ago, I was also impressed.
I don't think we go wrong either way.
I don't think we go wrong either way.
I mean and that's a great position to be in,
mm-hmm,
for us.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, not a great position for
one of the two candidates.
One of the two.
That's right.
However, it is an elected position. It will be up again at a point either in next May or the following May.
Right.
And there are other positions as well. So,
mm-hmm,
it's ways for people to always be. It also,
yep,
is tough on me because we have two people that want to do things for the town, and we're always saying we want more people doing things for the town.
I know.
And
I know.
And
one of them
in
was
essence
saying
has
go
to
away.
Turn one way. Yes.
Yeah.
That,
yeah,
sucks.
Yep.
So.
Now, we do have one person that's had a dozen years of experience doing things for the town almost directly in this position since July of 2007 as assistant town clerk. On the one hand, do we reward this person for being assistant town clerk for a dozen years and say, please move into the position of assistant of town clerk? Or do we say, let's try to bring another person along in town that's willing to do for the town and willing to learn for the town and hope that we still have the good help that we've had from the assistant town clerk for the last 12 years, that we have that for at least until May when there's an election. And then we've seen two people, and the town have seen two people, and the town can make the decision. And the three of us are a little bit off the hook.
I'm going to say, if she is more qualified, by all means, I will not be at all offended. I want the best person for the job.
I do too, and we've got one person that has had the opportunity to be in the position, learn the position, and know what the position entails, and we've got another person with a fire in her belly to learn more and do more. And there was a time in my life that was me, and I know where that took me and the things that I did. And, you know, I don't want to dampen that in someone else either.
The only thing I want to correct is the one term, the best. I don't know about the best, okay? I think they're both very good.
I understand
that.
Yeah.
And, you know, I agree with what you're saying, but I'd also say I bet that if being denied for one didn't ever dampen that fire, and I would hope
that
it wouldn't.
It will
yeah.
not.
Right.
Yeah.
I will
right.
move to the next
yep.
job that looks
mm-hmm.
like I can learn.
And, you know, well, that's important, and I hope both these people will still keep an eye on what's going on in town. And there are boards, there are groups, there are committees. I'm begging people always.
Yeah.
Put your name out to Ray. We'll find you a place. Probably more than one.
So, there's
yep.
people. Yep.
With that said, leaning on the 12 years experience, I'll make a motion to appoint Doreen Stevens as town clerk through May of 2021. The election of that, the end of this term.
May 17th.
I will second
for sake of discussion.
Further discussion?
And the date was?
May 17th, 2021 is the
end of the term rather than?
Yeah.
End of the term.
Rather than next election.
And I'll give you my thought process, whether it was Doreen or Susan is. This allows whoever's in the town clerk's position to go through a full cycle of elections without being on the ballot themselves. Learning the process and being responsible for the processes
mm-hmm.
without actually being on the ballot, which I think has to change things a little bit. I know when Linda has been on the ballot, she's had to step back and let Doreen do certain parts of the counting and other things.
Right. Right. So I've got a motion and a second. Any further discussion from either one of you?
Just looking at the two different resumes, it's really something to see. You each bring different things to the table, which is what makes it so difficult. You have different skills, and they both actually work well for that position, so.
And I had wondered before the motion was made about appointing one or the other temporarily for a shorter period of time and then letting the election figure that out, but you
mm-hmm.
made some really good points for that, Randy.
I've given a lot of thought to it over the last couple of weeks,
not
to the person necessarily. If I had chosen to make the motion to appoint Susan, I would do the same thing.
Said the same thing.
The date.
Right. Yeah. Yep.
I've given a lot of time, a thought to the date and whether I wanted to go through. Much like we did with Tom.
Yeah.
We had time to get him on the ballot.
Right.
But we went through the end of the term.
Yep.
Much shorter time for the ballot, but still, it made more sense that way. And as I've gone through everything, it just makes more sense this way.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't mean I couldn't support a May of 20.
Right. Yeah.
For a temporary town clerk to be having to think, I'm in charge, I'm responsible for this May 2020 election. but I can't be in the building because my name is on the ballot. That would be awful.
That was kind of where I, what forced me into the 2021 one is right there.
Right.
They don't, you know, there's going to be other elections that they can work through and learn the process, but the one with their name on the ballot is an important one to get through or have experience before you get to it.
Any further discussion?
Are these public documents now?
Yes.
Now, the one thing that hasn't been mentioned, which is that, which has, you know, holds a lot of weight for me, is the reference from our own
town clerk.
Town clerk, which is.
I have these electronically. I'll share that one with you, actually. What he's talking about is the second page. Linda had written long before, at least that we knew there was a second name.
Right.
Or that we even knew Doreen was, that was kind of presented to us all at once.
Right.
And I mentioned then with the retirement, and I'll mention again the fact that Harriet Tidd legacy lives on.
I would say one thing though. You are getting your accounting, your AS accounting and accounting, right?
Yes, I got that.
That's okay. There's a, there's also a FERCOG training session for
town accountants.
For town accountants that they're going to be starting. So that's also something that could be, I mean, looking at your,
I'd be interested.
Your newly acquired degree.
Yep. No, I'd be
I'm not sure if you even knew about it, but
I didn't.
It's something to look into. You can look on their website and sort of keep an eye out. I think it's going to start sometime in the fall, maybe.
I'd go on their website and look for Bob Dean, contact Bob.
Okay.
Yeah.
If you have a degree in accounting, if you just let him know that. He's always looking for people. And it's also a good way to get into the towns, because often with their town accountant program is you can work full-time. But not full time in Gill. It's a day in Gill, a day here, a day there.
Okay.
So it's pretty good. Mm-hmm. I think
that
we're going to save
that
a lot.
Just sort of stood
yeah.
out.
No, I'd be interested. I was.
Yeah.
I'm glad you thought of that.
Was
yeah.
going to look at UMass and see if they offered any type of municipal courses that I could maybe just even take.
Well, municipal accounting right now there is a shortage, and towns desperately need people to do the training and.
UMass runs a summer school
yeah.
on town accounting. The comical thing is you have to be a town accountant to attend the school.
Make any sense.
Which will not be the case with the FERCOG.
No.
Correct.
Yeah. Right.
So that's just something to put
that's
out there.
That's a very good idea.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right.
Any further discussion? Hearing none, not seeing any mouths open and close. All those in favor?
Aye.
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 And Axtell, I want to thank you again
yeah.
for
no
applying
problem.
And coming.
It was not an easy
and,
aye.
And,
no.
And
but
I want to say don't get away.
Yeah.
But also, you know, we're
check
happy
with
for Doreen
yeah.
and her service
yeah.
too. So
yeah.
you are both great candidates.
Now, can
so.
I ask a question?
Sure.
Is the assistant position going to become available, or is that something you're not going to fill?
That's a great idea.
I was
That's
hoping
a great
that
question.
The only person that will ever be able to answer that is the town clerk, because they are the only one that can appoint an assistant. It's an unpaid
yeah.
volunteer
okay.
position, but they are the only one by statute that can appoint an assistant.
Okay.
It's a great,
yep.
so great question.
So when Doreen gets her feet wet, that would be the question to go to.
Okay.
Yeah.
I can do that.
Great. Thank you so much.
That
thank
would
you.
Be perfect if you're doing the FERCOG accounting
yep.
course
yeah.
and your
right.
got
yeah.
your feet in the door above.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
That's right.
Yep.
Yep.
Thank you guys.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks
thank
for
you
being
soon.
Such a great candidate.
Oh, no problem. Thank you.
That makes up for making such a hard decision.
Well, I'm glad I made it a hard decision.
Any public service announcements, Ray?
People driving by may notice a very scraped-looking exterior on the Riverside building. The sheriff's office, community service program started the painting project today.
I saw it.
And it will.
It's an interesting looking building right now.
I drove by.
I'd call it Tutti Frutti.
I was gonna say, it's almost a work of.
I drove by, but I didn't wanna go too slow, so.
And then that's it for announcements.
No new business.
Okay.
All right, then, that ends the fun part of this meeting.
Question.